Hello everybody, what's new in the whole universe? I hope that everything is fine, and I'm a Russian man who brings value through my own experiences, and today we're gonna learn more Russian stuff. Russian entrepreneur stuff. And it will be kind of a lesson for you if you are a Russian language learner, because I understand that maybe someday you will move to Russia, or maybe someday you will appear on the our place, or maybe some people, entrepreneurs, Russian entrepreneurs, they will move to America and they will try to speak to you, and you have some connection with them through the talk that I will talk right now. We will discuss today and this period of time. What will we do? We have the federal law. It is a Russian language, yes, and about licenses of different types of doings. Doings means like labor, and you can do, for example, farm, yes, or manufacture, or maybe selling, or something. And what's the talk today on this channel? We will open the law. I will read it in English language, in English translation for you. I will read and translate, and you will have something kind of Russian words that you can read, okay? You understand? It is kind of language of only my translation, and you will read only in Russian. And you will understand what is it and what is it all about, okay? Let's dive into it. Why do I do this? Because I want to learn Russian laws, and I think I will bring you value if you will look at the pages, and you will try to understand it by your own, okay? And right now I will give you my Russian interpretation of this, okay? And I'm a Russian entrepreneur beginner of this doings, but I know many things. All what I need to, it is to learn rules of it. First of all, it is a Russian Federation federal law about different types of doings. Okay, you understand it correct. I think that I need to make it bigger this way, okay? Nice, I think so, yes. And it is by our parliament it made, and it means that, yes, it is established this day, 22nd of April 2011, okay, and also the Alliance of Federation said, yes, agree, we are going forward, okay. It is the list of different types of documents that we have, and it is kind of numbers that, Jesus Christ, it is kind of referral links to things. Next, it is our main possibilities, main definition, main things that we'll talk right now. First, paragraph number one, the fields of using this current federal law. And it is right in here. These current federal laws have a regulation to the relationships between federal organs, federal buildings, federal specific governmental places of the... It means, what is it? Исполнительная власть. It means the governmental power of doers. I don't know. It is a kind of... Understand it as a government, okay? It is government. Organs of government. It is all about some of the talk with linguistics, semantics of... It is government. And organs of our government... And of our power of subjects, subject means the subject, or maybe a specific city, specific town, specific maybe region of Russian Federation here. And about jurisdiction phases means kind of, I don't know, do you have it in your country? How do you call it? It is the person who has a jurisdiction power. Okay, if you have a, for example, individual entrepreneur inside of your country, or you are a specific company owner, okay, it is jurisdiction phases. Next, and individual entrepreneurship and entrepreneurs in a way of licenses, different types of doings. Okay, let's translate it fully. This law reglements something about the organs in government and the relationship between government and individual entrepreneurs because of the licenses of different types of doings. I hope you understand. Next. Yes, do you understand? If no, let me know in the comment section. I will try to write to you. Next. The paragraphs, положение, of this good federal law, yes, they are not doing, they are no uses for different relationship between things of licenses, and right now we have lists of them. Like, it is not useful for this type of things, and we don't use it for this list. First, for using atomic energy, nuclear, yes. Next, constructing or maybe doing manufacturing or maybe industrialization and doing the way of making vodka and alcohol. Etylene spirit means C5H12OH. Do you understand it? It means C12, yes. Yes, C5. C2H5OH. No. It is C2H5OH. It is the chemical thing. And alcohol and alcohol containing production. It is not for it. Also, the doings between secrets of government and protecting secrets of government, it is not useful for it. Next, it is not for creditable things and doings of creditable organizations. Next, not for doings of specific auction. Организованные торги, this. Организованных торгов means something like when you are organized specific auction, or maybe you are doing, you have an antiquariate, for example, and you sell it for someone, and it is organizational торги. I don't know what is it correctly, fully, but I think so, I guess, in this current moment. Next, doings of professional look at this. Types of professional doings on the market of ventures, or maybe of options, or maybe of the specific paper of, like, I don't know, do you have Apple, Amazon? You have stocks. It is stocks. On the market of stocks. Yes? It is different types of doings on the market of stocks. Next, doings of акционерных инвестиционных фондов. It means that, I don't know what it means. What is it, акционерных? It is stocks again. Stocks, investition and funds. Something like this. Doings on the... I don't know really what is it. It is kind of more diving into... Maybe if you are older than 40 years old, maybe you understand what is it. It is specific investition funds. Need to learn about it. I don't know what is it. Maybe it is the place where we can sell something. Or maybe you can try to have stocks. Stocks from Gazprom or Magnit. Or maybe Perekrestok. Different types of companies from Russia. And doings about management of... акционерными инвестиционными фондами. It means, again, this type of things. It is different types of... how to say it? Do you know? Do, doing, doer, when we have different types of ending on the words. Паевыми инвестиционными фондами. I don't know what is it. Really? What the word? You can Google. It is really hard word. I see this... not the first time, but it's kind of third or fourth. We don't use it in real life. Well, at least I didn't use it for my 23 years old. Right now I can see this and maybe I can ask some lawyer or someone who can say to me correctfulness of it. Okay, let's read next. and non-governmental pension funds. It means that we have governmental pension funds and we have also non-governmental, like it will be private, okay? Next, doings of specialization deposits of investition funds, and also again, паевых инвестиционных фондов, it means again investition of funds and non-governmental pension funds, okay? Doings of non-governmental pension funds about pension giving and pension страхование means when you have a kind of for example, you go to the healthcare. It is like a pension care. You go to the place, for example, to another country, and you are having specific care and specific agreement that if something will with your health will be not really nice, then they will help you. It means страхование. It means that when you have the issue with your health, or maybe pension, or maybe credits, you have something, or maybe with your car. Like, you save your car, and if your car will be crashed, you have some money. What is it in English language? Please let me know. And клиринговой деятельности. Clearing, what is it? Maybe. It is kind of clearing. It is about religion or something like this, because I know word cleric. Cleric is a person in Russian language who is doing something like a priest. Yes? Maybe about it. Next. Страховой деятельности. Again, it is care of things, doings. You remember this. When your car crashed or something. Next. Cosmic doings. Or maybe space doings, like SpaceX. And it is established in federal law from 13 of, it is what, the number 7, it is July, 13th July 2015, 216 of federal law, FASE, it means federal law, in short, abbreviation, acronym. Next, репозитарной деятельности. Oh, I said it in Russian accent, Russian, as you can say, репозитарной деятельности. Репозитарной деятельности, так будет корректнее. It will be more corrected. And репозитарной деятельности, what it means, I don't know really. Репозитарный, what is it? I don't use it in real life. It is real low, super low. And really governmental stuff that we don't use in real life. And let's Google it, maybe I will find it. Репозитарный, минутку, репозитарий. One moment. Место, где хранятся и поддерживаются какие-либо данные. It is the place when some different data is containing and supports. That's all. Репозиторий. I really don't know, maybe it is kind of archive. It is repository, хранилище, from English language, by the way. And it is, what we have? The place where we have different types of data, and in mostly cases, it is the files, and that are available on the distribution around the network. I don't know, what is it? It is maybe the meaning of, in a way of computers. I think it is terminology of a way of computers. We have different types of them. And what is it? Repository Yucca Mountain. Repository, interesting. Yucca Mountain Nuclear Waste Repository. Okay, let's connect it. Maybe you will understand what is it, this kind of nuclear things and also governmental things. Okay, thank you a lot for watching this video. I think that it's enough. You already know these types of things in this 4 of May 2011, by the way. We will read it next, maybe, if you want, because I am interested in it. And I think that it will be more good for you, it will be better for you if I will talk about something that I'm interested in learning too. Because if I have interest in it by myself, then I can bring you more value through this, because I'm really fired. Fired inside of me. And let me know, especially people who are learning Russian, was it interesting for you? What did you learn? And maybe I can speak about different types of laws in Russia, because laws is the way how really in a governmental type of speech people speak in Russia. Like, if you will go further, like, it is government talk. It is super, if you want to be a president in Russia, or if you want to be a person in government in Russia, then you should learn them. And it's really good for municipalitet, or maybe government regulation, if you want to go to this place, okay? I hope you understand. And why should you learn this? Because if you go and you will try to build a business, then you should know it. Yes? I think that it is a good, and we have a lot of opportunities, and we have not super big taxes in Russia, if we will compare it with your country. But even in your country you can create a business, but it is only like to understand the vocabulary. Right now you understand it more, and let me know if you understood, if not, okay? And I will try to bring you more value. And thank you a lot for everybody who was watching this video. I so appreciate it. We are going forward on our progress of English. We are learning new phrases. We are learning new stuff. And thank you a lot. See you next time. Be cool. And always improve still daily. Bye-bye.